Now, 16 WAPT's Joseph Pleasant takes us back to today's arrest and the murder investigation of Richard Barrett.
Investigators say only two houses separate where Richard Barrett was killed and where they say Barrett's killer lived with his mother.
I don't know what to think, you know. I'm afraid all this went on and stuff like this and didn't know nothing about it.
Alfred Lewis is Vincent McGee's stepfather. Lewis did not say if he thinks his stepson murdered white supremacist Richard Barrett, but he knew he was angry at the man for a day of work at Barrett's Utica home.
Because he said he went down there and, you know, did the whole yard and he pulled up some trees for him and he gave him $26.
Sheriff Wani Pennington described the injuries Barrett had when his body was found burning inside his house.
He had multiple stab wounds to the neck area, blunt force trauma to the head, fractured ribs, body burnt 35% of his body.
The sheriff says witnesses saw Barrett alive at McGee's home Wednesday morning. That led them to the man's home to question him. Once there, the sheriff say detectives found evidence outside that they used to get a search warrant to search inside the home. They found even more evidence, and McGee's mother gave them information.
Talked with her, and she told us what she knew, and that led us to get a warrant for him.
McGee was living with his mother after being released from Mississippi State Penitentiary in Parchman this February. He was there serving a six-year prison sentence. He was eligible for release in December of 2010, but got out earlier, due in part to prison overcrowding, according to Rankin County District Attorney Michael Guest. Back at McGee's home, his neighbor says he hates how Barrett died, but he can't help but being concerned for McGee.
If you ain't got no money, you can't fight that. And you got to go through this. Yeah, I'm afraid for him.
Rankin County Sheriff says McGee will probably go in front of a judge on Monday. But the district attorney for Rankin County says it's unlikely he'll get bond because technically he's still a state prisoner. Reporting from Rankin County, Joseph Pleasant, 16 WAPT News.
And we found out McGee was convicted of two counts of simple assault on a police officer and one count of grand larceny.